So good morning students, welcome back. Today we'll discuss the mathematical portion of error. Last time we did the theoretical part. Related to error, we discussed definition of error, types of error. Now today we'll discuss the mathematical parts of error. So first case are error in sum of two quantities. Whenever we add two physical quantities, so what should be the possibility of error that we have to find? So let's start. Error in sum of two quantities. Let students A and B are two physical quantities, and delta A and delta B are absolute error of A and B, So measured value of A should be written as A plus minus delta A. A is the measured value and delta is the absolute error in A. Measured value of B will be B plus minus delta B. B is a measured value and delta B will be the error in B, absolute error in B. Okay, students. So what will be the sum of A and B? Suppose Z is the sum of A and B of measured value. A plus B equals to Z. Okay, we know delta A is the absolute error of A. Delta B is the absolute error of B. And delta Z is the absolute error of Z, the physical quantity. So what should be the measured value? That is written as Z plus minus delta Z equals to A plus minus delta A plus B plus minus delta B. Actually, what we did? We represent the physical quantity with its error. Z written with plus delta Z, A written as A plus minus delta A, B written as B plus minus delta B. Physical quantities with its absolute error. Understood? Now students, A plus B, we separate the terms, plus minus delta A plus delta B. We took plus minus common. And we know students, look at A plus B, we assume in the beginning A plus B is Z. So this A plus B will convert into Z and Z to Z cancel out and we'll get finally delta Z equals to delta A plus minus delta B. So what will be the conclusion? What we got? We got the conclusion that in case of maximum, whenever we add the two physical quantities, in that condition, the maximum possible error will equals to the individual sum of absolute error of physical quantities. Okay, students. Now students, we'll discuss the second case, error in difference of two quantities. So same students, A and B are two physical quantities. The measured value of A is A plus minus delta A. A the value of physical quantity and delta A is the absolute error of A. B is the physical quantity and delta B is the absolute error of B. This is said to be measured value. Consider the difference this time, Z equals to A minus B. Now students, this time we'll write the physical quantities with its error. So Z written as plus minus delta Z, A written as plus minus delta A, B written as plus minus delta B. Okay, this is A and that is B. Plus minus delta A, when minus sign enter, so it will change plus minus as minus plus. So plus minus become minus plus due to minus outside and that become delta B. Now students, A minus B we assume as Z. So A minus B becomes Z. And plus minus delta A minus plus delta B. The most important thing for getting the, look at Z to Z cancel out and for getting delta Z maximum, the value, the sign of A and B, the sign of delta and delta B, the sign of delta A and delta B should be same. We want to get the maximum value, maximum possibilities of error. So for getting the maximum value of delta Z, both having the same sign, that's why plus minus minus plus become plus and we'll write as delta Z equals to plus delta A plus delta B. So this is the error in difference of two physical quantities. Okay, students. Now students, third case, error in product of two quantities. This time we'll multiply the two physical quantities. Same, A and B are two quantities. when we multiply, we'll get Z. So we have to find, when we multiply the two physical quantities, what should be the maximum possibilities of error in them. So let's, friends, we'll represent the physical quantity with its error, with its absolute error. So Z written as Z plus minus delta Z. A with absolute error will be A plus minus delta A, multiplication sign, B plus minus delta B. What we did, we just written the physical quantities with its error, absolute error. Okay, students. Now multiply these terms. A multiply with B, AB. A multiply with delta B, A delta B. B multiply with delta A, B delta A. And delta and delta B multiply. So it become plus minus delta delta B. Students, we know as Z equals to AB. So divide both the sides by Z, either AB. Here at left hand side will divide by Z. Z divided by Z become 1. There comes Z. Divide by AB become 1. Divide by AB, A to A cancel out. It remains B. B to B cancel out, remains A. And there A and B. We divide this side by Z and that side by AB because Z equals to AB. We divide both the side by same physical quantity, so it will not affect the results. Okay. Now, students, 1 to 1 cancel out. And look at delta A and delta B, both are the small quantities. Delta and delta B, both are the small. Okay, so this term should be neglected. So this term will be neglected. 1 to 1 cancel out. Here we get delta Z by Z, delta A by A, and delta B by B. So this is the maximum possibilities of error. This will be the form of maximum possibilities of error in the product of two physical quantities. Okay, we'll use this formula if two physical quantities are multiplied in error. Okay, students. This fourth case, error in division of two physical quantities. So consider the division Z equals to A by B. So here we'll convert the formula in with its absolute error. Z written as plus minus delta Z. Delta Z is the absolute error of Z. A written as A plus minus delta A. B written as B plus minus delta B. A and B are the physical quantities and delta and delta B are the absolute error of A and B respectively. Okay, nothing is common, but we'll take common A. So it remains 1 and it comes in denominator delta A by A. Nothing is common, but when we'll take common as B? When we take common B, it become 1 and delta, it become delta B by B. Okay, look, students, this term will remain as it is. This is A by B. A plus minus delta A by A remains as it is. 1 power. Transfer upwards, it become minus 1. Okay. A by B become Z. And by the binomial theorem, okay, what is the binomial theorem? We'll write in shortly. 1 plus x raised to power n. Using binomial theorem, when minus comes inside, it be plus minus become minus plus. Okay. We use this binomial theorem. 1 plus x raised to power n equals to 1 plus nx. Power comes in multiplication and there is a series, but here we'll use only the short form. Okay, so when minus comes in multiplication, big plus minus become minus plus. Now students, look at divide by Z both the side. Divide by Z both the side. So when you divide Z both the side, Z divide by Z, it become 1 and there comes plus minus delta Z by Z. When you divide by Z, it become 1 and multiply this term. 1 multiply with 1, 1. Delta A by A multiply with, so plus minus delta A by A. Okay. 1 multiply with delta B, there comes plus minus, there comes minus plus delta B by B. And finally, when you multiply these terms, minus delta A by A dot delta B by B. Okay, students. And see, students, 1 to 1 cancel out. Okay. And delta A dot delta B, that is very small terms. It should be neglected. Okay. So finally, there will remain only single terms. Okay. You can take a screenshot. I'm going to remove this portion. Look at, students. 1 plus delta Z by Z plus minus, okay, again I'm going to repeat this term. 1 plus minus delta A by A plus minus delta b by b, okay, and finally plus minus delta a by a dot delta b by b. This is the same term. Okay, now students, look, 1 to 1 cancel out, delta z by z, delta a dot delta b, both are the small terms. When you multiply, it becomes smaller, so that term should be neglected. And for the getting maximum value of error, both should have same sign. So delta a by a plus delta b by b. So whenever we divide two physical quantities, so what should be the formula of maximum possibilities error in them? This will be the formula: delta z by z equals delta a by a plus delta b by b. A and b are physical quantities, while delta and delta b are their absolute error respectively. Z are the division of that physical quantities, and delta z will be the absolute error of that division. Okay, students. So